to do abomination of the law. It's mentioned in the 1 Timothy chapter number 2 verse number 9. The woman should be dressed up with modesty, with shamefacedness and sobriety. They should not wear broided hair or gold or pearl or costly array. It's mentioned in 1 Corinthians chapter number 11 verse number 5 and 6, that the woman that prophesieth and prayeth with a head uncovered, her head should be shaved off. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter number 11 verse number 5 to 6, the woman that prays with a head uncovered, her head should be shaved off. Bible is more strict even than the Quran. Nowhere does the Quran say, nowhere does the hadith of prophet say, that if a woman does not cover her head should be shaved off. The Bible is more strict. Have you seen the photograph of Mother Mary? Have you seen the photograph of Mother Mary?
Yes, please.
Is the head covered or not? Covered. Why? For modesty. When you go to church, when you see the nuns cover the head or not? Yes or no?
They do cover their head.
They cover. Why? Because Bible says that. So what Quran says, the same thing is mentioned in the Bible. For modesty, you have to wear the hijab. If you don't wear the hijab, there are chances that you shall be molested. There are chances you shall be raped. In Islam, if any man, after these rules and regulations have been done, rapes a woman, he gets capital punishment, death penalty. Many people say death penalty is a barbaric law, is a ruthless way of life. Do you know in America, the maximum number of rapes that take place in any country in the world, it's in America. According to the 2008 statistics of the National Survey of the Crime Victimization, 203,830 cases of rape took place and 16% were reported. That means every day 3,590 cases of rape took place. Every 25 seconds, one rape is taking place in America. You know, I'm giving this talk since the past 2 hours. Already more than 200 rapes may have taken place since the time I'm giving a talk here. I'm asking you the question, if you implement the Islamic Sharia in USA, that every man, when he looks at a woman, he should lower his gaze if any unashamed thought comes. After that, the woman should wear the Islamic hijab, the complete body covered. The only part that is seen is the face and the hands up to the wrist. After that, if any man rapes a woman, capital punishment, death penalty. I'm asking you the question, will the rate of rape in USA, will it increase? Will it remain the same or will it decrease?
Please, it will decrease.
It will decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia and you get results. That's the reason Islam is a religion which shows you a way how people will respect the woman. In the Western world, they talk about women's rights, but what are they doing? They're selling their daughters. They're selling their mothers. They're selling their sisters. You know, the Western society talking about women's liberalization is nothing but a disguised form of exploitation of a body, degradation of honor, and deprivation of a soul. The Western society claiming to uplift the woman have degraded her to a status of concubine, to that of a mistress, and society butterflies, which are mere tools in the hands of pleasure seekers and sex marketers, which are hidden behind the colorful screen of art and culture. What is the Western world doing? They are selling their daughters. In name of women's liberalization, what are they doing? In most of the advertisement, you'll find a woman. How many women ride motorcycle? But you'll find a woman in the motorcycle ad. I was told about a very famous ad of BMW. You know BMW? It's a very famous car. It's a very fast car. Someone told me in one of the ads, there is a young girl standing in front of the BMW car in a bikini. And the ad reads, test drive her now. Who, the girl or the car? Test drive her now. Who, the girl or the car? What is the Western world doing? They're selling their daughters, they're selling their mothers, they're selling their sisters. In Islam, we respect our mothers, we respect our daughters, we respect our wives. Islam has spoken about hijab to uplift the woman, to give her more status. Hope you agree with this, that if the woman is covered, she is more modest and she gets more respect. Do you agree with this, sister?
Yes, please, I do.
Sister, do you believe there is one God?
Yes, please.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ is God? Do you believe Jesus Christ is God?
Yes, I do.
You believe?
Yes, please.
Sister, if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me. If any Christian, including you, can point out a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says, I am God, or where he says, worship me, I, Dr. Zakir Naik, am ready to accept Christianity now. I am not speaking on behalf of my other Muslim brothers and sisters. I am ready to put my head on the guillotine. In fact, if you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28. I cast out devil with the Spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20. I with the finger of God cast out devils. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God is a Muslim. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was a Muslim. He never claimed divinity. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God, not God. A man approved of God amongst you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. So when nowhere does the Bible says Jesus, peace be upon him, is God, so why do you believe he's God? Because the church says so. Do you believe in the Bible or do you believe in the church?
I believe in the Bible.
Where does the Bible say is God? So someone has told you a lie. So now when you have come to know the truth, nowhere did Jesus say that he is God, peace be upon him. I have given you so many quotations. So yet do you believe he is God? See, the brother who came earlier, he got convinced. He's seen my cassettes. He's seen my lectures. I'm asking you, yet do you believe Jesus is God?
According to the Bible, Jesus Christ came to die for our sins and was crucified.
Sister, you said Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, came to die for a sin and he was crucified. Yes. I told you earlier, sister, just before you, I proved that according to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die on the cross. I told in the earlier answer. Did you listen to my answer, sister? Did you listen to my earlier answer?
Please, I didn't hear you all.
I quoted to you Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 40. That Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. And we know Jonah was alive, correct? Jonah was alive in the belly of the fish. So even Jesus Christ was alive, that means he did not die on the cross.
Please, I'll be happy if you can please explain to me how Jesus Christ died.
You are asking me to explain how Jesus Christ died. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die. So how can I explain to you died? As I told you, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says that as Jonah, you know Prophet Jonah? As Prophet Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. When Jonah was thrown overboard, was he dead or alive? Sister,
alive.
Was alive. In the belly of the fish, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. When the fish vomits out Jonah, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive, alive, alive. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Now when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was taken on from the cross and put in the sepulcher, in the tomb, was he dead or alive?
Please, the question again.
Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. You told me Jonah was alive, correct? In the belly of the fish. Jesus Christ, after he was brought down from the cross, he was put in the sepulchre, in the heart of the earth. When he was put in the sepulchre in the heart of the earth, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. That means he did not die. So if he did not die, how can you say that Jesus Christ died for our sins? It's mentioned in the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 18, verse number 20. The soul that sins shall die. The father shall not bear the iniquity of the son. Neither the son shall bear the iniquity of the father. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him. The wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him. But if the wicked turns and come back, he shall not die. So sin cannot be inherited according to the Bible. One human being cannot die for the sins of the other human being.